Before we get into this four-song meditation, I'm going to review the purpose of the meditation and some pointers. But if you want to skip right to the meditation, just click the box and it'll take you right to the beginning of the meditation. So what is the purpose of this four-song meditation? Number one is I want to provide some instruction. I want to provide skillful means to engage the emotional body. We don't have enough of that in our culture about how to go in and make the emotional body a functional part of our life, make it an enlivening part of our life. We just don't get that information. We get a lot of mental information, but what happens with that mental information is we try to manipulate our emotional state to make us feel better. We do not need to do that. The emotional part of our being has an intelligence. We don't access that intelligence because we don't spend time with it. And so part of our intelligence is missing. Number two, I want to help provide some structure. If I just say, hey, play four songs and go feel your feelings, you're probably not going to do that. I wouldn't do that. We need some structure so that we can get started, so that we can have someone maybe who has gone down the trail a little bit ahead of us and show us something that they found. Along with the structure, also my purpose is to provide accompaniment. My purpose in making the videos is not for you to watch me dance and scream and cry to music, although that might be entertaining as it may be. It is to provide some kind of safety and accompaniment so you will take the step, so you will put on that music, so you will start the investigation and the opening of the heart, the stirring of the emotional body, the processing of the emotions. And lastly, my purpose is to help give you permission to express your feelings, give you permission that your self-expression is valid, no matter what it looks like, no matter how foolish we might feel. Look, we got a lot of shame about our feelings because some of the feelings that we have are dark. We don't feel we can share them. We feel that we would be judged if we did share them. And I'm trying to set a context and a tone of no judgment, permission, investigate those feelings, let them come out, become familiar with them, because as you may have heard me describe before, when the feelings are neglected, they become mutated, they become harmful, they become a mutated form, a little dark, a little ugly. When we engage them, they start to open and untangle from this mutation and start to become powerful forces in our life. There is an intelligence in our emotional body that we don't have access to because we simply don't have a culture that knows how to show us how to use the emotional part of our body. Instead, we get books and mental ideas and motivation to try to manipulate the emotional body. But it has its own intelligence that if we pay attention, if we stop, if we let them be heard, if we let them be felt, they start to unfold and start to show their intelligence of decisiveness, of assertiveness, and of deep feeling and meaning in life. That's what you get from an unfurled emotional body. So the analogy is just like if you take any human, an adult or a child, and you put them in solitary confinement, they become mutated from what an open, healthy, happy human being is. We have done that with our emotional body, not purposely, we just don't know what it is and how to be with it. And now in this time in our planet development, some of us are now looking into that and going into that territory and finding out how to unfold these feelings and how to develop them. So that's the point of this meditation. Why do I use headphones? Because headphones give me a way to turn up the volume and get out of my normal state of consciousness, disrupt my mental pattern and really feel the music and let that feeling penetrate into my body and start to stir things up that I'm not wanting to feel. But the headphones and the music give me something familiar and safe to go into those feelings I don't want to go into. If you just sit in a chair and start to try to go into your feelings, you can do that, but it's a harder way to access them. So the headphones and the music seem to help a lot. You'll see me poking at my computer. I have a playlist on iTunes where I go and find these songs. As I'm feeling the movement of the music, I'll pick the next song often. I don't have preset playlists usually. All right, so that's kind of the purpose and explaining some of what you'll see. The first song I use in this one is to crack open the feelings, disturb the numbness, and start to get something moving inside. I'm out of touch often when I start these meditations. Eventually you'll see me screaming, picking up a hoodie and screaming into my hoodie. That's to access the anger that's coming up. And now remember, anger isn't a positive or negative feeling. Anger is what happens when our self-assertiveness is repressed and we have hurt and pain about that. So to reverse that process, we need to be in touch with the anger, let it have space to be. And it comes out of its mutated state of rage and frustration, or being the nice boy or nice girl. It comes out as balanced, socially appropriate assertion when you unfold it. So it's not ugly. It's not dark. It needs a place to be so that it can function and operate properly. After the second song, you may notice in my eyes, you'll see the lights are starting to come on. This is kind of what happens, and this is why I do four songs, is because I end up moving through a complete emotional cycle in and around four songs. And then the fourth song is where hurt and mourning comes through. I don't always know the why of why I'm crying. I don't always know what I'm feeling, but we all have so much mourning of the losses and the hurts that we experience in life. We under-mourn. We don't mourn enough. So you don't need to know why the tears come. You just want to allow the tears to come. Let them come. And then you'll see me saying things to myself like, I love you. I love you. And I have a little graphic, I think, that highlights that. So that's where I'm getting through some of the pain and arriving on the other side of the mourning process to feel that love inside. Mourning is how we get from where we are to where life really is. So as we're crossing that bridge from where we are to where life really is, there comes a sadness and a pain of letting go, and then into an arrival at where life actually is. And when we arrive, we feel love. We feel that inner connection. We feel like a piece of our wholeness comes back to us, because the part of us that was stuck in the past has now come into the present moment so that we can utilize that piece, so that piece can integrate and become a part of us, so we become more. It's like a power-up on a video game. You power up level by level. The more we take the pieces of us that are stuck in the past, mourn that feeling, and bring those updated and current into what's happening now. If you find this work helpful, please share it and please spread the word. It could be helpful to others. And I hope that you have some deep insight and some deep movement from the meditation.
Sights on awaking dreams. And I'll keep love together.
Myself coming. I just much life running through my veins, going to waste. And I need to feel real love and love ever after. I cannot get enough.
Just an hour ago, you listened to their voices, lilting like a river over underground. And the light from downstairs came up soft like daybreak, dimly as the heartache of a lonely child. And if you can't remember a better time, you can have mine, little one. In days to come, when your heart feels undone, may you always find an open hand and take comfort wherever you can, you can, you can. And oh, it's a strange place. Oh, everyone with a different face, but just like you thought when you stopped here to linger, we're only as separate as your little fingers. So cry, why not? We all do. Then turn to one you love and smile a smile that lights up all the room. And follow your dreams in through every outdoor. It seems that's what we're here for. And when you can't remember a better time, you can have mine, heart feels undone. May you always find an open hand and take comfort. There is comfort. Take comfort wherever you can. You can, you can. Ooh.